Gut feelers, today we're going to talk about a subject that is highly requested from you, and that is the side effects of spirulina. If you've ever taken spirulina and you might have had a side effect, you maybe have searched YouTube or other sources like, what is this all about? Why do I have nausea? Or maybe you even experience vomiting. And this video is for you. Make sure you stick with me to the end, where I give you a recipe which actually helped me and also helped clients if they have any issues with spirulina after we talked about and you checked your spirulina. And including this recipe is gonna help you to have less of those symptoms and get more of these amazing, amazing health benefits. Now let's dive right into it. What's it about? What's about spirulina and its side effects and how you can avoid them? If you watch any of those videos, I talk a lot about spirulina and its health benefits. I still stand 100% behind this. It's one of the best foods you can eat to heal. And it's been around since the earth is born. For example, did you know that a lot of the oxygen that we have now in the atmosphere is actually coming from, part of it at least, from spirulina, from the production? This is an ancient, ancient food, also for known since 5,000 years by the Aztecs. They started incorporating that in Mexico. People just eating that. So don't think about it as just as a supplement. It's actually a really potential food. It's incredibly nutrient dense, contains GLA, which is a fatty acid, beta carotenes, all kinds of minerals, nutrients. Then it also helps to boost your immune system. So if you have any autoimmune issues, this is actually a good thing to incorporate. We're going to talk about that in a second. Supports heal your liver, allergies, the list just goes on and on. Diabetes is also a big one. It contains high amounts of high quality, high absorbable, bioavailable protein, up to 60% if it's dried. And this is probably why the UN in 1974 declared this food as the best food for mankind, or also the food of the future. Isn't that amazing? Now, I understand you might have taken spirulina and now you feel like, oh my God, there's something happened in my body. I don't know what. It's probably toxic. Should I keep taking it? I'm pregnant. I have thyroid issues. I have autoimmune disease. I take medication. What's it all about? This is what this video is about. One of the main important things you need to know about spirulina is that it's very resistant. It's very resilient. It can grow in conditions, in very harsh conditions where other microorganisms can't grow, in very polluted areas, and spirulina will survive. This is a powerful, so it has a lot of potential. However, one of the main qualities from spirulina is, and that's also a healing benefit, that whenever it meets in its environment, may it be in your body or outside, it binds to toxins. Environmental toxins, toxic heavy metals, other pollutions, pesticides, herbicides, so it will bind to it. Now in your body, that's great because it binds to it and then it transports it out. But if spirulina meets it outside, it also absorbs the toxins. So one of the main reasons, and this is really a big one, where people experience like major, what people might think is a detox reaction, which actually is an intoxication, like vomiting, increased heartbeat, abdominal pain, a lot of thirst, nausea, like really like an extreme aversion to spirulina, is because you might have had a not good quality spirulina. Actually, most of the spirulina produced nowadays, they are not healthy for you. Two origins that definitely need to be avoided for where spirulina comes from is Japan and China, where they found like increased amount of a toxicity from the spirulina. Nowadays, how spirulina is produced, if it's produced for consumption, is in man-made or natural lakes, where it's then harvested and freeze-dried. One reason why you might experience vomiting is not because of the spirulina, but because spirulina, if it's not controlled really well, also thrives in an environment where other blue algae, where other algae are thriving, which produce toxic waste that are actually damaging for your liver, for example. And that's the other factor. So we talked about the pesticides, herbicides, any kind of toxic waste that goes into the water, and then spirulina is still happy and growing, but it's also binding to those toxins. Most people think like, okay, then I would just get organic spirulina. Well, that's not enough, because there might be also those other algae in there, because the FDA in the US is not controlling spirulina right now. And even if it would, it's still not 100% sure. To make sure it's a good food source, spirulina should be controlled in every step of the production. So not just in the beginning and not just in the end, but also what they're doing in between and how the toxicity and the contamination, if there are any flare-ups. Really hard to find a good brand of spirulina unless you know the production, unless you were there and you watched everything. But I'm personally still working with Hawaiian spirulina from Nutrex and also Vimergy spirulina, which is recommended. They were both recommended by Medical Medium. Spirulina is not a highly allergic food in any way. It's only if you have a lot of toxicity in the body, you might have a few symptoms. But if you experience like vomiting and really strong reactions, you are not taking a good spirulina supplement. Now, what about autoimmune diseases and allergies against seaweed or seafood, things like that? In the part of seafood and seaweed allergies, I had a client actually who couldn't take spirulina because of that. Then we improved the liver, we improved the overall health, we improved her liver, and now she can take spirulina. So if you have the rare seafood allergy, you might want to be like really gentle in the beginning. First improve your health and then go back to trying out just a little bit. What about autoimmune diseases? Clients come to me, they say like, I have Hashimoto's. My doctor says like, no way I can take spirulina because it boosts the immune system, contains iodine. What should I do? Guys, the whole autoimmune issue, if you still believe that your body is attacking itself, then you should really not take spirulina because for your mind, you're gonna get crazy. But the whole message of this channel is that your body knows exactly what it's doing. Your body, like no other organism, will ever start attacking itself. What it attacks is viruses, is toxic cells in your body. But your immune system didn't went crazy. It knows what it's doing. If you have autoimmune issues, taking spirulina can actually help you get out of this. I know this is super controversial, no doctor will tell you that. The good thing about that is most doctors don't believe in spirulina anyway, that it can do anything. So they also won't tell you don't take spirulina. Most important thing is that you trust your gut issues. If you have autoimmune disease and you think, oh my god, can be toxic, then just take a little bit and experiment with it, or seafood allergy or anything like that. It's safe to take if you're pregnant. It's a superfood. It's really a food. It helps you to get stronger also through the birth process. So no worry about that. Now guys, before we come to the end, I'd love to know from you, have you tried spirulina? If so, did you have any side effects, or did you have any health benefits? What was your experience with spirulina? Let me know in the comments below. Share your knowledge with other gut feeders so we can all benefit from your experience. Last but not least, what to do if you're not good with spirulina or you want to just boost your health and get your energy back. I recommend Detox Heavy Metal Smoothie from Medical Medium. I put the recipe in the description. It contains barley, grass juice powder, and Atlantic dulse, and banana or any kind of other fruit that you want to include. Of course, the superfood wild blueberries and spirulina. Anthony Williams in Medical Medium shares that this combination is perfect for drawing out the toxins from your body and then binding them also in different stages, in different organs, in different stages of the digestive process. This is the fast track and the most efficient way to detox your body from heavy metals. I hope this video was valuable for you. If so, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and also make sure to ask your question if you have anything more about spirulina in the comments below. Thanks so much. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.